Or was that the entrance?
Mm.
Yeah.
It's simple, it's funny, it gets the point across. And that's what we do here. Get the point across. Where's the little burger man? Contrary to popular belief, this is not a leather couch, and this is not a very, very bad porno.
Is it?
It's not. I just said it's not.
Fuck.
And I've got the spotlight again.
Hello everyone and welcome to Somnia. I am Kia.
I am Sarah.
And today we're doing what's going down in tabloid town.
We got some interesting news stories for you guys today. I've got Mick Jagger still kicking after his heart procedure that is in very poor taste.
Wow.
Slipknot have released their own brand of whiskey as well as some new songs that have been released this month. Kia.
Yeah.
What have you got?
Not a lot, actually. No, I've got a story about Pink Floyd and basically
climate change.
Climate change. That's really cool. No, and then I've also got what's going down in the whole gaming world with the whole difference between Pokemon Go and the new Harry Potter wizard game. So that's...
Yeah. So let's get to it. In 3, 2, 1. Now before we get started, here is my chicken stripping, and I'm not talking back here.
This isn't a porno.
Anyway, speaking of making a quick buck, which no one mentioned, but I'm going to throw it in anyway. Slipknot are releasing their own brand of whiskey called No 9. Now, they've collabed with Cedar Ridge Distillery, which is also an Iowa-based distillery, in order to get this out. It is going to be released on their North American tour. There's been no talks as to when it's going to be released in Australia, though I am hoping that when they do support Metallica for their tour this year, hopefully we might be seeing a taste of it. If not, hopefully it comes out in bars soon. But yeah, make sure you check that out, as well as their new album that's being released this year. Do not forget that they've released All Out Life as well as Unsainted. Now before anyone comes at me about, life is not on this, it might be on this album. Think of Doomsday, think of Architects. Doomsday was on Holy Hell. Don't fight me on this. I know what I'm not talking about. Thank you. But that's basically the update on what's happening there. We all love whiskey. Well, as Australians, we do, so maybe you guys out there as well. We kind of need something new because we're getting over the old damn shit.
$5 wine's a shit.
Yeah, that shit is $5 wine, public service announcement. Can fucking handle anything.
So, Pink Floyd's David, what's his name? Gilmore. Pink Floyd's David Gilmore, who's the guitarist and also the singer-songwriter. he's actually donated 126 of his guitars to the climate change company, Client Earth. And he's raised $21 million for it.
And we've seen none of it.
Yes.
We are climate change.
We need change. No, anyways, he's given away the black Stratocaster, which is in songs known... Yeah.
I can't believe it.
So if you guys don't know what the black Stratocaster is, it's basically been in songs including Comfortably Numb, Shine On You Crazy Diamond, and also Money. So that's kind of that's a huge deal.
Yeah,
dude,
that's,
you know?
Mental.
Like, that's mental. Yeah.
Far out. Well, I can't believe that. That's actually made me really heartbroken.
But basically, the reason behind the whole donation towards climate change and Client Earth is because he said, and I can't quote this word for word, but basically he said we need a civilized world where our grandchildren can grow and continue playing and singing songs to help the world and everything. So I just think that's really beautiful. But it's really beautiful.
It's so beautiful. What an icon, but that whole band, Pink Floyd, is just an icon. They always have been. So
yeah.
But good for them.
But David Gilmour is also actually known for just donating a whole bunch of stuff to different charities and everything. He's just really humble about it. He doesn't talk about it. He's just like, yeah, you know, like, I've got money. I have it, you know, like, you have better use for it.
Exactly.
So let's do this.
21 million, though. Like, hopefully they figure out what's happening with climate change. Otherwise, that 21 million's going to waste.
You hope so. No, but anyways, Client Earth have also responded and they're so grateful about it, but we'll leave everything in the links below because I can't quote word for word. This thing's a mess. Most days.
Education with Kia.
Hey!
Speaking of throwbacks, since we've just been speaking about Pink Floyd, frontman Mick Jagger from the Rolling Stones has actually come back on tour following his heart valve procedure. They had to postpone some of their North American dates back in April due to this procedure, but he's back, his signature dance moves, he's singing his heart out.
Poor bad player!
And not only that, he's actually just had a kid at 75 years old. He's like a rabbit. Someone get the guy a TV, please. 8 children. That's 6. 8 children.
It's been a really rough day.
It's been a really rough 23 years, actually. Sit down, let me tell you my problems. So they ended up kicking back where they left off in Chicago, Illinois, which is one of the further dates in their North American tour. And as I said, he's back and he's got it. It's like nothing happened. That's why I really, really admire old school rockers, because they just go out there. You know, back when like Motley Crue and Ozzy Osbourne and shit were just like doing drugs every single day and not sleeping, and they were still out there every single day putting like everything they had into this. That is Mick Jagger. He's also had 8 children. I'm never gonna get over that. I hope some one of them is talented, because otherwise, man, what a wasted opportunity. But that's all I've got for you guys today. Not really.
What if like moves like Jagger was actually him, about him like having 8 kids? Like, he got moves, dude.
But anyway, if you guys are going through North America and want to hit the tour up, they'll be there for a little while. Other than that, he has said that he's probably going to slow his road on touring now. They're not going to do it as much as what they used to, because they kind of need time to rejuvenate. They're not young like they once were, and they do need a break just like all of us. So kudos to Mick Jagger for coming up bigger, better and stronger than ever. And congratulations on your 8th child.
Buy a TV.
Anyway.
That's metal worthy.
That is, yeah. He's a champ. Honestly. Anyway, King is up. Go on, what's with your games?
I am very accepted here. So basically, I'm going to talk about a little bit of gaming stuff as per usual, but basically...
What's that?
So anyways, Harry Potter have come out with a game that's similar towards Pokemon Go, and it's called Wizards Unite. Wizards Unite? Wizards United.
Wizards Unite. I think it's time for a concept time, because I've got an idea.
Yo.
I've got a smart one up in here. It's got the brain.
Alrighty, let's jump.
Alright, it is concept time, guys. Alright, so our concept today is actually about what if they made a Star Wars theme, like Pokemon Go and all that sort of stuff. Like, for example, we've kind of got it in two different ways here. Kia's idea was that, like, you know when you used to play Pokemon on your Game Boy and you would like walk through the areas and you hit a certain piece of grass and all of a sudden like you were battling with another Pokemon. And then my idea was, in like Pokemon Go, you know how when you like move your camera around, it'll stop on like someone you need to battle, like Snoke, Palpatine, Jabba the Hutt, or you even get a chance to see like the Sand People and things like that. And I think that would be a fucking awesome idea. Because I know personally, I'm not really a massive Harry Potter fan. Like, I've seen some of the movies, like I've never watched them consecutively. And I love Pokemon, but like I love Star Wars. Like, that's one of my favorite movies. And I think it'd be so cool to see a Pokemon Go version of Star Wars. Not like those gay ones you see with like Game of Thrones, where you have to like build your castle and shit.
Oh, and then you have like time limits and you can, whatever.
Yeah. Yeah. And shit. And you even get to verse, like you can even be, like I'd love it if you could be Darth Maul with like the double-ended red lightsaber. Like, that would be cool. And like every step you go...
Or what if you find, you know, like that's part of what you find, yeah, or what you hatch.
Yeah. Yeah, like, yeah, cool. You, like how in Pokemon, how you were able to like pick up things like ropes, hammers, bikes, all that sort of stuff. Like in that form, yeah, like you can pick up Darth Maul's lightsaber after you defeated him, or like Palpatine's lightsaber once you defeated him. And then like you can even get like Palpatine's powers once you've defeated him. And then we all have to watch Mace Windu fall through a window again. It's like a storyline. They should just make an actual game, like a cool version of the game. But anyway.
Get onto it, fellas.
Yeah. Please. Some of us over here are dying to play this game. But anyway, alright, that is concept time. Kia's back with her story.
So with this Wizards Unite, it's kind of like Pokemon Go in the sense that you have the map, you know, like you're running around and everything, but there are some little differences that kind of make it unique in its own sense. So instead of gyms, you have fortresses, and basically you can pair up with someone else. So say for instance, me and Sarah, we can tackle this thing together. And instead of Pokestops, you have inns. Alrighty, so basically Wizards Unite is the same same but different when it comes to Pokemon Go. So with Wizards Unite, it's like you're trying to get foundables. Now these foundables can be like little creatures, it can be little artifacts, it can be anything. Or you can even unlock people, like trying to get rid of the spell and everything. Instead of throwing a Pokeball, you do the movement of the wand, you know, like as if you're actually doing a spell, so it's kind of cool in that kind of sense. You can catch them and they can get away. Same kind of like concept, but at the same time, very different because it's a different storyline. One of the main differences between this game with Pokemon Go is it follows more of the storyline. So it's got more dialogue to it. It has more like fluency in it in the sense of the movie. And it's just like, yeah.
I think it's really cool how they like put objectives through.
Yeah.
Like for Pokemon Go, it was just like, oh, you caught a Pokemon. It's like, if I wanted to do that, I'd just turn on my Nintendo DS.
But yeah, with this, instead of gyms, you have fortresses. Instead of Pokestops, you have inns. It's the same kind of thing. It's made actually by the same creators of Pokemon Go. So they've made it just for the other people. Yeah. You know, like for the people who follow Harry Potter, it's just like everyone except for you likes Harry Potter. And then, you know, like everyone else likes Pokemon Go. So they've kind of attacked both areas, which is really cool. You know, like good on them. They've made a good game, good app.
Yeah, and for full disclosure, I don't hate Harry Potter.
You just don't watch it.
I just don't watch it.
So the difference with Pokemon Go and this one here as well is there's more of a storyline to it as well. Like you'll find that it's kind of like the end of Harry Potter. It's like he's trying to continue living his life and everything, you know, like Lord Voldemort's gone. He's just basically showing what his life would be like after, you know, yeah, like what we don't get to see, yeah, like in the next Harry Potter film. So I don't know, it's kind of cool. But yeah, this one's available on all your Apple, Android, smartphone devices. So make sure you download it. It's going to be pretty cool.
And to end you guys off, I'm not going to give you an article or explain a story. I'm actually going to just let you know about some new releases that have happened this week. I was meant to do it last week and I completely forgot throughout the segment, so I'm going to do it this week. I've got about 6 songs here that I want to let you guys know about. So the first one is a new release that just came from Sleeping With Sirens called Leave It All Behind. Now, yes, we were promised Heavier. However, there were no breakdowns in this song. None. And Kellen Quinn, why were you not wearing shoes? That's what I want to know.
That's freedom of expression.
But they've come back and they've hit it well. The song is absolutely amazing. Definitely check that out. As well as for Pride Month, Stan Atlantic and Alex Leahy, both Australians, teaming up to do a redo version of Skinny Dipping. It's absolutely amazing. So just a little bit of a background on that story. The lead singer Bonnie Fraser was interviewed. She said that the song was basically her way of saying how she felt because she couldn't quite understand who she was, obviously, with her sexuality and her as a person. And it kind of is just a sum up of that for herself. And Sum 41 released another song as well. This one is called All in the Family.
Yeah.
It's basically based on coming from a broken home. It's, they've come back with 3 great songs so far, so I definitely cannot wait for that album. Northlane released a second song, Talking Heads. In my opinion, much better than Bloodline. Heavy, lyrically done, and they're following suit of kind of like growing up in an abusive as well broken household, so they're following that theme. And they do put out pre-warnings for the song because their storylines are actually very, very intense. So if you are prone to getting upset or anything about those sort of ones, just remember what the songs are about.
I love them.
Pumped Up Kicks, Riders, Foster the People are back for their psychedelic tune, Imagination. For all of my indie fans out there, make sure you check that one out because it's absolutely booming. So there's another one for you. I wasn't sure whether or not I actually wanted to talk about this. Why? Because growing up, Blink-182 was one of my favorite bands. And it really, really sucked when Tom DeLonge decided to leave the band. And there is a very large Tom DeLonge-shaped hole throughout Blink-182.
It's because of George.
How dare you bring it up again? Now, they've released a 50-second video for a new song called Generational Divide. Now, I'm not sure how I feel about it. A lot of people in the comments are saying that they're feeling a lot of old school Blink-182. I personally am not looking forward to the new album, though I probably still will listen to it because, as I said, you know, I back Blink-182 100%. So it's very, very, very punk rock. Very quick, very straight to the point. Again, it only lasts for about 51 seconds. So I am personally very confused as to whether this is the official video because that's what it said and that's what they said when they released the song, or whether it's just a little bit of teaser before they actually show it to us.
So check that out if you're interested. I probably won't talk much about the Blink-182 new album, but obviously I'll let you guys know once that comes out. But those are your new releases for this week. Write them down, listen to them, show your grandparents, show your family, bring it out at Sunday night dinners, whatever you feel right. But yeah, that is your rundown for songs released at the moment.
Now guys, make sure you also know about our podcast. It is released every Tuesday and every Friday. We also have
What's Going Down in Tabloid Town, released every Thursday, as well as some new stuff coming as of this week, so make sure you keep an eye out because it's going to be funny. We did hurt each other a little bit during this one, but it's
a lot.
I headbutted Kia, but you'll see that in due time.
We also have a Spotify playlist as well. If you missed out on any of our songs in the podcasts, make sure you check it out.
Exactly.
It's pretty good.
And follow us on social media because we are kind of funny and I make some pretty good memes, so...
Yeah,
not to brag. But with that, it's time to say goodbye. I am Sarah.
And I am Kia.
And this has been Somnia. Peace out.
By the way, guys, make sure that you check out the links below because that has all the information that we have spoken about, and Sarah's just a fucking weirdo. But anyways, peace.